Welcome to Mr. Criminology, where we share for you to learn and succeed. In this video, we will be discussing Article 172 or falsification by private individual and use of falsified document. Falsification by private individual and use of falsified documents. Sa crime na ito, may tatlong acts na pinaparusahan. First, falsification of a public, official, or commercial document by a private individual. Second, falsification of private document by any person. Third, use of falsified document. Let us discuss each. First punishable act, falsification of a public, official, or commercial document by private individual. Ang document na included dito sa first act ay public, official, or commercial document. So, hindi po kasama ang private document. Ang pwedeng liable dito sa una ay private individual. Pwedeng public officer or notary public, but he or she did not take advantage of his or her position. Na-discuss na natin sa Article 171 yung 8 acts of falsification. Pero yung pang-7, hindi yun nakukumit ng private person unless in conspiracy siya sa public officer, employee, or notary who took advantage of his or her position. So sa Article 172, first punishable act, nakakumit yung accused ng isa sa mga acts of falsification, tapos yung document is either public, official, or commercial, tapos yung accused is a private person. Second punishable act, falsification of private document by any person. Ang document naman na included dito sa pangalawa ay private document. Tapos ang liable ay any person. So private individual, public officer or employee, or notary who take or did not take advantage of his or her position. Ang requirement lang dito sa pangalawa ay may damage dapat sa third person. Yung damage is not required sa first act of falsification but it is presumed. In other words, yung accused who is any person ay nakakumit ng isa sa mga acts of falsification except the seventh one. At ang falsify niya ay private document. Dahil sa pag-falsify niya na yun, nag-cause ito ng damage sa iba. Third punishable act, use of falsified document. Yung falsified document ay gagamitin either sa judicial proceeding or other transaction, provided there is damage or intent to cause damage to another. Dito sa third punishable act, yung nag-falsify at gumamit ng falsified document ay magkaibang tao. Yung nag-falsify ay yung nag-commit or accused sa Article 171 or yung nag-commit or accused sa first and second punishable act sa article na ito, Article 172. Kung ginamit sa judicial proceeding yung falsified document, damage is not required. It is already presumed. Example, nag-present ka ng falsified receipt showing na nagbayad ka na ng utang mo. Kung ginamit naman sa ibang transaction yung falsified document, damage or intent to cause damage to another is a requirement. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to share it and to subscribe.